What up, everyone? You're now tuned into my podcast, Difficult People Chronicles, and I'm Seriously Focused Johnnie. So today I want to talk about how to get yourself unstuck. What I mean by getting yourself unstuck is that sometimes you come across people who will say certain things to you. They might call you names or say something indirectly in a roundabout way, meaning, say, for instance, you have a friend who's been talking about you all along, and then let's just say in actuality, she's really not your friend, but you think she's your friend because you don't know that she talks about you behind your back. In a way, you finally see her true colors, that she feels some kind of way about you. So in a roundabout way, she starts talking about fat people or something. You know that you're on the heavy side and you're working on your weight, or you might just be content with the way you are. But the fact that she's talking about you in a roundabout way hurts your feelings. And then you get home and you get stuck, meaning you get depressed and you start to ruminate. You find means to satisfy your either sadness or depression, because you know words can kill your spirit if you allow. So you want to get yourself unstuck. Now, for me, like when I went to go take my cosmetology exam, the technique that I learned in school wasn't what was on the exam. Like you do a live model and you have to roll a set the hair and things like that. And what I learned in school, you know, I did hours and hours and hours of preparation. I did hours and hours at home, everything else. And then I get to the exam the first time when I looked around and I saw that the technique that they taught me in school wasn't the technique they were talking about, I basically turned around and walked out. So I didn't even complete the exam. Then I signed up again. In any event, it was crazy. I ended up acing the exam. Had I allowed that one person to tell me that I couldn't be a cosmetologist, I would have been stuck, you know. I've had many people in my life, not a lot, but handful, who have walked into my life. And, you know, a lot of times your enemy can see who you have the potential to be, and they will try to stop you in your tracks. And I've learned at this stage of the game, there's certain things that I allow to affect me. Like if, let's just say you're hanging out with a bunch of friends and then that one so-called friend says something that's like rude, and you know all along you've had that person's back, but that person's not supportive of you, who you are. Yeah, that's like a wolf in sheep's clothing. So one of the things that I notice, which is important, is that I notice that when I get angry, I eat. It's like every 5 minutes I'm at the fridge. So I've learned that I'm just going to push away from the fridge for certain things. Like I eat my regular meals, and then that whole snacking, over snacking, when I'm angry, has to stop. And I have to push forward. So that's my message for you all. Push forward. Let whatever someone tells you, take it like a grain of salt. You know, with diamonds, in order to make a diamond, you have to apply pressure. So if you are a diamond, be able to withstand the pressure. So you're going to always have someone who wants to be that one person to knock you down. You know, it's kind of like the concept of crabs in the barrel. Don't look down, because 9 times out of 10, those people in the barrel, they're not for you. And it's that one person in the barrel, or a few people in the barrel, that's trying to come for you. If you have more than one hater, then sometimes you're doing something right. That's what I was told by one of my guy friends. He said, you know, you gotta have more than one hater, and know that steel sharpens steel. And let people know that, you know, they don't affect you. It's all about getting your mind right and have a healthy mindset, because you're gonna meet a whole lot of people in your lifetime that's gonna either try to prevent you from getting promotions, stop you from whatever your game plan is, to maybe even trying to take something away from you that you was working so hard for. You're going to meet all sorts of people. And these are some of the things that people need to teach their kids: how to bounce back. So make yourself sharp enough that you'll be able to handle resistance. Yeah. So that's for you guys later.
And for more episodes, you can catch me on Apple iTunes, Google Play, Podbean, Spotify, Overcast, Pandora, and iHeartRadio.